my state is inside A. It does not have contribution from any other IL state. So with certainty it's going to be thrown in this state. It will remain in this state. So when I do a momentum measurement, then I'm going to get back Pk root 2 Mpk. Right? Because it's always going to be exactly in that state. Yes?
If you wish, I could write after. So after this measurement has been made, one measurement has been made, I get back psi k, whose energy is E k. So if I were to write in terms of the momentum eigenfunctions, the momentum eigenfunctions are exactly the same. Yes, because momentum commutes with the Hamiltonian. So if you wish to write as a linear combination, then this is it. The new state is exactly this. If you wish, you could write this as Ck C square, where C is equal to 1. For certainty, this is the state. So if this is the state, it can't be thrown into any other eigenstate. For certainty, the probability is C square, right? So always it's going to be thrown in psi k, and I'll get my momentum eigenfunction, eigenvalue, sorry. For certain, there is no uncertainty. But yesterday you've already seen that sigma x, sigma px is greater than h cross by 2, which means there is an uncertainty. Now, even after this measurement, my state stays in the same eigenvector, psi k. But the moment I do an x measurement, what will happen? It will be thrown off from this eigenstate. Let me show you how. Now, it is in the eigenstate psi k. Just fall back, if you have difficulty in imagining, fall back to the two-dimensional analogy of ij and I prime j prime, which I showed you. So any function I or j, I can write as a linear combination of I prime and j prime. Like that, I think that psi k is a state, not an eigenstate, is a state in the position space. So till now we were talking of momentum or energy space. Now psi k, consider this psi k to be a function in the position space. So now I have position eigenfunctions. Okay. So which means that psi k can be defined as sigma of I ci zeta, ci square zeta, ci zeta I, where these zetas, zeta i's are position eigenvectors. Yes? So, I have done a momentum measurement on the system.
It's pi.
Yes? Yeah, pi.
Pi was defined as sigma.
So, I described two experiments. One, I did on pi, I came to some state k, whose energy is ek, vector is psi k. Then I do a momentum operation, I measure the momentum of the system. So, I will be in that state for certain, I will observe the momentum corresponding to that state only, not to anything else. Now, I can again start with phi k or I can start with psi k, doesn't matter. Because position and momentum are non-commuting operators. So, I will always have an uncertainty. So, think about it, I mean I start with psi k, no problem. I can write this psi k as a linear combination of my
position eigenfunctions, right? And the moment I do a measurement of position, one measurement of position, I'll get, now k is a dummy index, so don't think that this k and that k is related. If you are really worried about that, then these are position eigenvectors, then I could write xi as position eigenvalues. Okay. Right? Huh? What? C is a con- exactly like you did earlier. You wrote phi is equal to ci psi i. I am just writing psi is equal to ci zeta i. It's exactly the same thing. Except my basis vectors earlier were energy eigenfunctions, now they are position eigenvectors. Earlier they were ij, now they are I prime j prime. That's all. Now, when I do this operation, so finally I guess if I write an analogy to that, this is what I should get, right? The average position should be this. Well, of course, one thing is there, and whatever I'm writing is slightly wrong because position is a continuous function. So I should be rather writing integrals. But let's just stay in this discrete space. Okay. So I'll get some particular position. Oh, I nahi hai na, yahan pe m hai. Okay. Attendance bhi chahiye. Okay. So, if I do one measurement of this position, the system will be thrown into some eigen state of position. Okay. With the probability that it will be Cn squared. The probability of being thrown in this particular eigenstate would be Cn squared. And in general, since these two operators are not commuting, I don't have a common set of eigenfunctions, complete common set of eigenfunctions. So in general, this particular eigenfunction will not be in the same direction as one of the sides. Yes? So if I get the eigenvalue as xn, I will be thrown into the eigenstate of zeta n, which will not be collinear with any of the sides.